Welcome to System Sailing. I'm Wally Cross. Today I'm sitting on an S279 on a beautiful summer day in Detroit. A cold front just came through, so the sky is clear and humidity's down, the temperature's down. It just feels fantastic to be back on the water. I'm hoping you have an opportunity to get on the water soon. Today we're going to talk about tactics, system sailing tactics, the tactician. And it's interesting, when you talk to people about different tacticians, they're kind of referenced as the quarterback on a football team, or the pitcher on a baseball team, or maybe the point guard on a basketball team. A person that is somewhat in charge, in control, has to make a lot of really important decisions. Yet this person shouldn't necessarily separate themselves from the team, thinking that A, they're more important, or B, their job is harder, or C, they have to bear more responsibility for the outcome of the race. They truly are just another piece of the crew puzzle that'll ultimately fit within your system. I've had the pleasure over many years of sailing and racing with some of the finest tacticians in the world. And it's always interesting to me to watch them do their job. They all have different systems, all have different characters. I guess that's what makes them so unique. But a lot of them do and do not include the crew. You know, some of the better ones, in my opinion, do involve the crew because that makes the crew feel like they're really part of the team. But I've sailed with plenty that are quite good that'll pretty much do their own thing. You know, some are quiet and are always thinking in their head but not out loud. And then some, of course, are extremely vocal, very emotional, and sometimes flat out entertaining to sail with. But again, this individual should not bear all the responsibility of the race. They should just be another piece, like I said earlier. You know, what's fascinating to me is just breaking down what I think is important in system sailing to get that end result. And the end result we're trying to all get to is to win a race, or win a regatta, or win an event, or to place it really well, to beat our goal, or at least to achieve our goal, but maybe even beat it by one or two places. So as I've talked earlier before about system sailing, I first and foremost put the emphasis on boat speed. Because as I grew up sailing, tactics was not my strong part. So as I started looking at what I thought really would contribute to making sailing work for me, I put a lot of emphasis on making the boat fast. And that's what we've talked about already, all the things we do to make your boat really, really fast. And then just last week, we talked about boat handling, and that's number two to me. So if one is boat speed and you're fast, the second should be boat handling, how you get off the starting line, how you tack, how you jibe, how you round marks, how you hoist, how you douse sails. So by being fast on the water and then next having really good boat handling, and if in fact you can get off the starting line, you're gonna look pretty smart more often than not. But still, tactics is a big deal, and I put that under the category of decision making. So if we have boat speed, we have boat handling, and the third category is decision making, which tactics falls under. But what also falls under decision making is strategy. So think of strategy as all the pieces or the ingredients that make up a pie, everything that goes in to making those good tactical decisions during the race course. And strategy should include the whole team, because this is the kind of information you get before the day of the race, maybe a week, 2 weeks, a couple days, the internet information, the geography of the race course. Maybe you're talking to some people that have sailed on that body of water before. You're doing your research. You're trying to figure out what is it like to sail at that place, at that time and date. And the next part of the strategy comes all that information that we've discussed before about before the race, the pre-race, when you're getting out there an hour ahead of time. When you're getting all that information, sailing upwind and downwind. And then again, you're talking as a team. You know, do we have the right rig? Do we have the right sails? Do we like the way we're going across through the water? What side looks good? What side has more pressure? What has less? What's the current doing? Everybody should be involved in those discussions. And the way I look at strategy is imagine if you got all that information and you started by yourself with no other boats around. Strategy would be pretty much how you sail that race with no other boats, just by yourself. It's a plan, it's a thought process, and based on your thought process and information, you're pretty confident it's going to be a good one. Now, where tactics come involved is when you include other boats. When boats are all there, it's those real-time decisions that you have to make regarding other boats, as well as keeping your strategy in mind. So when we look at tactics in a sailboat race, I like to break it down in a variety of different categories, starting with the pre-race, the information that we get before the race, to the start itself, because that has to have a system. I'll tell you about my system. And then the way to look at every leg, leg one, leg two, leg three, and leg four. In my mind, each leg has to have a system, sort of a goal that I sail by, so that when situations happen, I keep in the back of my mind, what was my goal? What was my plan to get through leg one, to get through leg two, to get through leg three, leg four, and then ultimately the finish? So for example, if I break those categories down and I start with the pre-race, this is when we're getting out to the race course 1 hour ahead of time. And again, I emphasize, to me, that's really important. Not too much more than that and not less than that, but 1 hour, you're starting to sail upwind, and every 5 minutes you're tacking. And during those tacks and during those times you're sailing upwind, you're recording not only the wind direction, the wind speed, but you're also talking in conversation about how you're going through the water, your target speed, hopefully against a competitor. You want to base all your decisions against someone you're testing against, so that if 6'2 might be in your target theoretically, yet it looks like 6'1 is making you more competitive for that day because the water's flatter, then that's what you should say. Hey, look, 6'1's our target today. As well as, how's our rig set up? You know, we thought base would be a good setup right now, but maybe we're not sailing as high as we want. Possibly we should be a turn or two off. That's all the information that you're accumulating when you're sailing upwind for the first 20 minutes. And then you'll sail downwind for 20 minutes, getting similar information, but a little bit different. Now downwind, and hopefully again, you can sail against a competitor. You're sailing downwind and you're looking at your true wind angle numbers relative to another boat and saying, hey, is this a good number? Is this a good target number? Good target true wind angle number? But also downwind, you want to think about, how's our trim? Not necessarily just the trimming of the sails, although that's important. You know, is the luff breaking too soon? How is the curl on the asymmetric or the spinnaker? Is the leech open? Is the main leech open? Is the top telltales flying? But how's the trim fore and aft? Are we bow down? Are we bow up? Is the transom too far in the water? Are we heeled enough to windward? Are we too flat or too far to leeward? All those thoughts, all those ideas should be discussed while you're practicing going downwind in that pre-race. Again, and this is all just bringing information together so you can put your strategy together that will affect the tactical decisions. And then 10 minutes, that's 40 minutes. Now we have another 10 minutes to get the starting line information. And this is where you're using a starting tool like a Velocitech, some tool that determines where the starting line is, to get your ping at the boat end, then get your ping at the pin end. And this is when you're sailing really slow on starboard and someone on the bow has got their hand up. And as soon as the bow is right at that point of the flag or the pin, the hand comes down, someone makes a mark on the computer or the box, and that determines where those two points are. And then for me, it's always important then to go to the midline, right to the middle of the starting line, and have the bow individual judge where the line is in reference to your ping, so you have confidence that your information is good. So that's all the pre-race information. And of course you want to get your two ley lines, the ley line at the boat end and the ley line at the pin end, so that when you know you're in those positions, that's as far as you want to go on either side. With all that information, you still have 10 minutes, and this is when the crew should sit back, get some water, Gatorade, and hydrate, yet talk about the plan. What is the strategy now? We got all this information from days ahead of time to now, from what we just did. This is the strategy. This is what we want to do. This is our plan. So now we go into the starting sequence, and again, it relates strategy now to tactics. Now, I've got my own system for starting. Again, it doesn't mean my system should be your system. You just need a system, because when you have a system for starting, it takes all that nervous energy and kind of just calms everybody down, because everybody kind of gets what you're trying to do. And my system is always at the warning gun. I'm on starboard tack by the boat. because that's where I start my system. I make sure I got all the course information if it wasn't broadcast on a radio. And I just am really, really clear what the race is going to be, aiming towards the pin end. And then based on time, I'll come back on port depending on where we want to start. So if the line setup is set that we want to start more at the boat end and we like sailing more towards the right side of the course, I'll start coming back at 3 minutes. So we started at 5, we went down the line for 2 minutes, now we're coming back at 3 minutes. Theoretically, we should have about a minute to kill up by the boat end. If I want to start more in the middle line, I'll come back at 2 minutes. More at the pin end of line, I'll come back at 1 minute. That's just my strategy. But the whole time, that's actually my system, but the whole time, that individual that's talking about distance from the line will be given meters from the line. So in light air, we might just be traveling 20 meters off the line. Medium air might be 40, and in heavy air, it might be 60. Some distance that would increase based on wind speed. And then once we tack onto starboard, the final tack for the line, that information from the line has to be constant as well as the time, so that you know if it takes your boat to go 5 meters in 10 seconds and it's you're 6 meters away 10 seconds to go, pretty good chance you can put your bow down and get the boat going. So that's your system. Now you've started. This is where tactics come into play now. Based on your start, you need to make decisions. Now, assuming you got off the line well, you had a good start, and again, you know you're fast and you have good boat handling, then it becomes a little bit easier as a tactician because now you can kind of let the race play out. You're hanging in there with the group of boats, and when boats start tacking away, you can decide either if you want to go left, you go left, or if you want to stay with the boats that have tacked away, you go right, or maybe you go up the middle. Those decisions, like I say, become easier because you're in control. You're going fast and you had a good start. But let's just say it wasn't a good start and you had to tack to get clean air. And this is the part of the race that I've made a mistake so many times, is that even though your plan might have been to sail more to the left side of the course, yet you had a bad start, but now you've tacked and clean air on port, you kind of sometimes talk yourself into, well, maybe the right's okay. But remember, if you are fast and you do have good boat handling, look for that first opportunity to go back left, because you're going to get back into the race if you stick to your plan and you're going fast and you got good boat handling. If you go off to the right, which is different than your plan and particularly different than where the better boats are going, you're kind of just guessing. And sometimes a guess works out, but usually it doesn't. And so as we go up this leg, this is leg one, halfway up the leg, this is where I start thinking about we're getting back inside the cone. My thought is, all right, now we're halfway up the leg. If our side is not really working out, or if it's just been average at best, we got to figure out how to get back to the center of the cone. And the cone is, if you can imagine a line from the top mark off on starboard tack, and another line off on port tack, lay line, everything inside that is a cone, the upwind cone. Halfway up that beat, I personally like to get somewhere near the middle of that cone so you can set yourself up for that final shift before the top mark. As you're reaching the top mark in leg one, the decision there has to be, now if I'm coming from the left, I want to make sure on port tack, I'm at least 3 boat lengths away from the mark on port as I approach the fleet that's coming on starboard, just so if you are tacking to leeward, you're not in a fouling situation. And just the opposite, I don't want to set up too far away from the mark on starboard because too many boats can come and tack to leeward of you and give you bad air and just make it tougher to get to the mark at a fast VMG. But also what you're thinking about as you approach the top mark is what's going to happen on leg two. How did the wind change relative to the course? Are we going to be jibing soon or starboard tacked a long jibe? Those are kind of the things you need to discuss with the team so they know how to prepare for those decisions after the top mark. But usually on leg two, my first goal in system sailing is to set, settle, and make sure you've got clean air. And then after you've got clean air, I like to think about getting on the long jibe, the jibe that is longest for that leg or most in line to get to the leeward mark, or in this case, maybe gates. That's early on. Halfway down the leg now, I'm thinking on leg two, we need to start thinking about which gate we want to round and how to set up for that. Meaning, if we want to round the left gate, we may want to sail on port jibe longer, so when we come back on starboard jibe, we're more inside. Or just the opposite. If we want to round the right gate, we may want to sail longer on starboard so that when we're coming on port, we're on inside. And then as we approach the bottom mark tactically, now we want to think about making sure you're on the inside, and then also knowing that you need to round the mark wide and tight so you can hold your lane when sailing upwind. But now leg three becomes interesting because you've got all this information from leg one. So when you're sailing leg three, all that information that you learned from leg one should kind of go into your plan for leg three. And this is where you can kind of change your tactics based on your position. If you're leading or you're to that top group, you're going to want to kind of just be a little bit more conservative and stay with the better boats or stay with the fleet because A, you know you're going well and you've got good boat handling. But if you're a little further back, and you saw what happened on leg one, which might have been different than what you planned on, there's a good chance it's going to happen again. You may want to leverage that side. Or often, I'll just kind of keep an eye on where the leaders are going and maybe leverage to that side. But unlike the first leg where we want to get back to the center of the cone upwind, and the second or the third leg upwind, I like to leverage to what side you think is going to work relative to either where the leaders went or what worked on leg one. Now, as you're approaching that top mark again, now we're setting up for that final leg, leg four, a little bit different. I'm talking to the crew about, all right, we want to get on the long jibe quick. And that might mean setting and jibing right away. That might be a jibe set, or that might mean just setting and settling if it's long on starboard. But on that final leg, this is where you want to make sure you're on the long leg for a long time, the long leg. And then also, like leg three, we want to leverage what side we think is really going to pay coming into the finish line. So those are just some ideas for a system that works for me. But what's really important in system sailing, and of course the way I sail, is I have to have everybody in the team involved. I'm not one of those people that will just say, everybody stay quiet, you know, I've got this. Because there's so many smart people on the boat. So I want to hear from what's going on from the bow when he talks about wind coming in 3, 2, 1, waves coming in 3, 2, 1, or someone on the rail saying competition, the fleet's up on the right, or their bows are down on the right. Where the boats are up on the left or down on the left. I see more pressure right, I see more pressure left. I think we're doing the right thing. I'm worried about where we're going. All that information really, really helps, as well as including the speed team, knowing that we're sailing the right target speeds. Because if we're lifted and we like the way we're going, we may want to speed up our target a bit. But if we're headed and we're looking for an opportunity to tack and get across, we might want to slow our target speed down a bit. So all that information makes a tactician's job, his or her job, just a lot easier because the decisions become more obvious. And when the decisions are obvious, you'll find that everybody on the boat is on your side. And when you've got that team support, I'm telling you, the power of a team is so much more powerful than the sum of the individuals. So those are just some of my thoughts as a tactician for system sailing. I look forward to speaking to you again here in the future. My name is Wally Cross. This is System Sailing.